And we're back to learning Midjourney. Let me show you the shorten command. It can be used to understand prompting a little bit better. Let me paste a very long prompt right here. It's about a girl in Hong Kong in the streets, neon lights, and a lot of words that aren't necessarily needed in the prompt. You can access the shorten command right here, paste this entire prompt. Keep in mind that the aspect ratio will be ignored. And when you now confirm, you can see there's an analysis of what are the important tokens in your prompt. A couple of words now have this strike through. You can use the new shortened prompts and regenerate your images, but as I've said, they won't have your parameters. So add the aspect ratio, for example, right here. Let me go over all five and I reprompt them and they get shorter and shorter. So it's always the same thing that Midjourney will give you. The first prompt is longer, the fifth, the last is the shortest. You can click on show details and then you can actually see the weight of the important tokens. For example, Hong Kong has the highest. And right here, Hong Kong has a weight of 0 because Hong Kong was already used right here. And there it has a weight of 1. In this diagram below, you can see Hong Kong, neon, woman. These are the most important tokens. Then intelligence, vibrant detail and stars. And this is why the last prompt has exclusively these words. And it even omits the last one, stars. Let us check the official documentation while Midjourney runs in the background. So I'm under user guide, commands shorten, and here it is explained with an example. It highlights the most influential words, called token here, or tokens. Here's a long one as an example, and it makes it shorter and shorter, and even the short ones, they look like the original in many aspects. So most of these words in the original prompt were unnecessary. And by using the shorten command, you can understand how Midjourney works and how the bot interprets your prompts. So here was the very long one. And now we're getting shorter and shorter. And it's still the same style. Still a woman in Hong Kong, neon lights, vibrant city life. You can also see that at some point it changes a little bit the style. So the last two are way more focus on the woman, and the woman is much more realistic than in the first ones, but still it's the same style with much shorter prompt. I'm going to link to the official documentation as always, so check it out yourself, and it's a good tool to understand this prompting and improve your prompt engineering. I hope this video was helpful. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.